We recently learned that the long dormant lunar landing program has become a new priority for our current administration, which envisions someday establishing human colonies on the moon. Now, I'm not sure what life would be like in such an environment, but we can imagine what these people might have in mind. Here on the Sea of Tranquility, it's a good life that we've come to know. It's a planned community, a place where we can be, far from all the problems on the earth way down below. Madras spacesuits are in style, and the golf ball soars a mile, and the people are the type we'd like to meet. No gangs and no graffiti, all the indigent and needy are getting under someone else's feet. It's a lovely place of exclusivity today, a population based on the ability to pay. But now it seems it's getting very crowded down there, and the powers that be are saying that we are going to have to share. They promised us a little slice of heaven, a lunar enclave for the lucky few. We pay association fees, live this life of ease, lots of heavy taxes for the view. The color brochure made it very certain there'd be no strife like that with which the world is strewn. So we don't really care how much the earth below is hurting, we don't want no public housing on the moon. The covenants were supposed to be airtight, like the dome that lets us look out at the stars. Single family residence with purchase preference given to the following, you know who you are. But now they want to tear down the border and stick a pin into our beautiful balloon. Open fire on our environ, bring destruction and disorder. We don't want no public housing on the moon. We don't mind the manufactured air and the constant meteor showers, or the hydroponic moss on which we dine. But it would be unfair to construct those high-rise towers filled with all the people that we thought we'd left behind. We have no prejudice, we never would refuse anyone for how they look or how they pray. If you need proof of this, just ask that nice family of Jews. We took a vote and narrowly decided they could stay. See, we're just like you, we need dentists too. Our menial tasks have all been automated, so employment is a thought you ought to banish. You can keep your teeming masses, we've no jobs for lower classes, and our robots never badger us in Spanish. And if we let them come and build a slum here, our way of life will fade away like Brigadoon. Living at the summit, but our home values will plummet. We don't want no public housing on the moon. We're tolerant at heart, you know, so this must be stressed. To equality, we are not averse. It's not that we believe we're so much better than the rest. It's just that all the rest are so much worse. We know just what they're doing. They say, why not let a few in? But that's the road to ruin. We're no fools. Watch their number as it multiplies. You know these types all breed like flies. Soon they'll want to vote and put their children in our school. They'll send their little thugs to sell our darlings drugs. Everyone deserves a neighborhood to live in, and we hope they find a home sooner or later. But to the limit we've been driven, and we're not gonna give in. Put them anywhere, just not in our back crater. And though it's right that all men should be brothers, our world would crumble like a stale macaroon. It's a private satellite, so if you let us have our druthers, we don't want no public housing on the moon. We thought that we could get away, we thought this privileged place could stay safe, secure, spoiled and immune. So let's keep this just between us. Once they're here, we'll move to Venus. We don't want no public housing on the moon.